Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back. We are back with Sufferwhite Joe here, playing the best deck. Yeah, after 1 year, he finally added Schism to his deck. Very nice. So yeah, you played Invoked and Dogmatica last week, and you won the local. And I asked my YouTube, "You want to see the deck profile?" And they said yes. So here we are. Anything you want to say before going to the deck profile?
Not really, this deck plays itself, basically.
All
It's
right.
not the same list as last week. Last week I played a little bit differently with a bunch of hand traps, but I streamlined it for today, so this is the list I will play today.
All right, cool. So the better list. All right.
Yeah, pretty much. So Alistar. Duck my balls.
All right, triple Ecclesia.
Yeah, so last week I didn't play this. So I played this package. And I think it was Herman Hansen and Ryan Yu who played this to number one on DB. And they played two Maximus. In testing, it didn't really come up to play two ever. Opening it is kind of good, but you play six ways to search it, going first. And it's actually a way to go into your Shadow engine without opening this, just opening Ecclesia, which normally doesn't happen. The Fleur is there to search off the Titanic Legend extra deck. And two punishments for the three Ecclesias. It comes up a lot.
Okay.
Then still a small Shadow package. I built this deck with Raphael last week, and these were the last cards that got into the deck. I played only this going first, with the Nadirs. And then we had five spots, so we just flew this in because this card's broken going second against Tribrigade or anything. And it's just extremely good going second. And with the extra deck, I play the Camomera Flecia, it's called, and Verte. So I kind of wanted to keep it in. So I can dump this from the Maximus to get search for this for turn three. Or turn two, I can go into Verte to actually just send this and win.
All right, that's a Predaplant Chimera Flecia, right?
Chimera Flecia, yeah.
Chimera Flecia. All right.
So Ash and Gemma. Gemma's the worst, but it's like nice if you get drilled turn or game two or three. It's also nice if you just open Nadir Servant. You can just go into, like, they'll probably Ash it if you start with that, and then you can just Gemma them. And Ash comes up sort of when you open Maximus or Ecclesia because you can normal summon this to go into Secure Garden Almirage to still get your Shadow engine going. And Gemma's just the most impactful hand trap going second, so that's why I played these six. And then finally, triple Pot of Prosperity, triple Tactics, and one offs, one Call By, one Terra, and one Mine. Yeah, this is the last spot, the Mine. It's just there for sake of being there. An extra target for terraforming, I
Mystic
guess.
Mind Gamers.
Yeah, exactly. So that's 40 in the main.
Okay, cool.
So for the extra deck, of course, the Predaplants, then Almirage Secure, and Gravity Controller. This doesn't really come up, but it's very strong going second when you open Shadow Fusion. Otherwise, it's meh. It's like a turn three card because you summon your Shadows with your Schism usually in the extra monster zone, so you can link it away for controller to actually play and not be under your own window. So that's why it's there. So I played two Macabre, one Agoides, and Purga Trio still. This card is just nutty.
Yeah.
It's free OTKs.
It's insane that so many people got it before. It's such a good card.
It comes up quite a lot, and when it doesn't come up, it's like, yeah, I'd rather play it and it doesn't come up than not play it and have to, like, oh yeah, I really wanted to have a fire here,
Yeah,
Purga
missed an
Trio.
easy game, you know.
Yeah, and it's also like it could come up versus certain decks like Salamangreat or maybe even Tribrigade in these scenarios, or just with an Ash sometimes. So it's kind of nice. Agoides is probably the best one, and then Macabre just two for the turn one play. Then Shadow Monsters. I don't think these need any explanation. I don't even know when to play Construct. It's like it comes up when you do the play without Nadir Servant.
Yeah,
So
you
you.
can do like Shadow Fusion, summon Construct, send
Yeah,
Schism, link it
exactly.
away for controller. That's really it.
That's basically why it's there, yeah. And final three cards are Maximus targets, so Titanic Lad. Antis and Omega. And Omega is, of course, also for the Gamma main.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah, I can see you activating Shuttle Fusion and then being Ashed and just having the Gamma.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, cool. Anything spicy in the side deck?
Not really.
Oh, two mine.
Lancia for Dragon Link. Drytron's still broken.
I feel personally attacked by this side deck.
I mean, it's like you need this for Drytron because you're never winning going second. Even though like Shuttle Fusion, Magical Meltdown, Nadir Servant is nuts, you're like in the fairy variant they still have like Fornicate, so you still lose. And the Megalith stuff, they still have like Dweller and Pop 4, so you're still probably losing. Storm might be Twin Twister if Anti-Spell gets back into the format. But right now Storm is just more impactful versus stuff like Eldlick, which also sees kind of a lot of play at our locals. And Judgment is just going first for the Twin Twisters and stuff like that. This could also be a pointer, but they can chain, of course. So
Yeah.
I want to play Judgment for that. Lancia, Tri Brigade, and
Yeah, Lancia's
Dragon Link.
super strong this format.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's basically it.
All right, cool. So, anything else you want to add to that?
Not really. I'm just playing this deck for a couple of weeks and then I'm switching to Dragon Link or something. But it's this deck's actually kind of good right now because of win now. It's just nuts.
Yeah, it's surprisingly versatile, and I've played a lot against this deck, against you, against Zara, and it's really good for no real reason because it's still the same deck. It's just more refined.
Yeah, you have a bunch of bad matchups though, especially when because I play the Stall cards, of course, and the Gammas in main, and opening these cards versus a trap deck just sucks. And that happened quite a lot.
Yeah, I can
And
see that the only decision package is better at that point.
yeah, but then you got to fill it with more hand traps, which still suck against those matchups. So like the
Yeah.
blowout for Shuttle Fusion versus decks like Virtual Rod or Tri Brigade just dies to one Shuttle Fusion.
And you don't feel like Cyclone in the main might be good since this is sort of a mid-range deck?
Not really. You want all your cards to be like either insane or engine-wise relevant.
All right.
So like Nadir, Alistar cards, and then Shuttle Fusion is an engine card which gets you into your follow-up. And the Gamma is just a really powerful card. I don't think Cyclone solves anything for this deck. Maybe only like counters to order, I guess.
Fair. And you've never missed any additional shuttles in the deck as well, or?
No, if I wanted to brick, I would play Virtual Rod.
All right, fair enough. All right, cool. And yeah, thank you. I
No worries.
hope you do well tonight. I like the deck. It's surprisingly to see it's still alive for some reason. And yeah, shout out to your Twitch channel. His link is in the description down below. Suffer Waijo. And shout out to the bird. Bye, guys.